Hi, so let's learn today the SQL Server patching. So today session we will make something interesting for SQL Server patching. Normally we feel like that the SQL patching is quite boring things when we got a chunk of server to do the patch, okay? So we feel like that it's a boring task. So today session we will discuss something interesting and we'll make the patch, different ways, and we'll do the shortcut and we'll see how can we get the benefit. So when we got the chunk of server, okay, so what are the manual the checks and all we can avoid with. So today's session we will go to discuss a little bit different way to patch the chunk of server when we got the chunk of server, okay? So once again, welcome to my channel, guys. Tech and Art, okay? So hope you guys doing well. Whoever new on my channel, please like to subscribe. So let's jump to the topic. So as you can see in the screen, today I'm going to discuss about the patching method. As we all aware, the pre-checks and post-checks about the SQL patching. I'm not going to discuss pre-checks and post-check. I'm just going to discuss one of the method which can help you when we require to patch a multiple server, a chunk of server. So we are going to use the PowerShell script. Okay, so objective of this document, if you see, to avoid the manual logging into the every machine and then patching the servers. The advantage is when there are more than one machine to be patched. So as I said, when you got the patching for the chunk of server, so no need to do the patch every server manually and then do the checks and all. So what kind of benefit we are getting here? So we only need to check the %dev folder log file to verify the result where that server is patched or not. Okay, so you just only need to read the log file. Okay, so if you come to the overview, what are the things required to do this setting? So here you required, I just left the names which I used. You can change it according to your environment, your suitable names and all. So as you can see, we have a table named patch server in our centralized inventory SQL database, sysadmin server and server name, which contains the entry of the server which are going to be patched. Okay, so here we are talking about we have a centralized inventory on a placed in a the maintenance database. From there you can pull the reports what are the server need to patch. Okay, and there you need to place the executable, the exe file on each server. You need to create this directory csql server patch sp folder. Okay, so you need to create this directory under C and you need to place the executable, what are the respective server included on that patching change. Okay, so now you can get it from here, the structure of the sample data in the table. If you create you need to create a table here. There you can mention the server name, you can insert the server name, that's it. Okay, you just execute this command, it will create a table name in a maintenance database, and from there you can keep the server name. Okay, so here just describe the little bit what are the things in here. Only the server name column should contain the server name, remaining should be should contain the hyphen and null. Okay, so only the server name column should contain the server name, remaining column should be hyphen or null. Okay, so if you come down here, the what are the steps to execute these things. So first check is you need to check the winrm service should be started on each server, what are the server included in the patching. So you need to check the services.msc, and that services win.rm should be started because we need to establish establish the remote connection. Okay, and now if you come to go down, so what it's saying, going to centralized SQL server where you can access all the SQL Server and create the below table in your maintenance database. So if you look at this point, so everywhere we have a, you know, it's a kind of jump server. From there we are connecting the all SQL instance. Okay, so over the jump server we can create a, you know, the maintenance database. Okay, and from there in the maintenance database you can create a dummy table, temporary table, and you know, this is only for the first time. No, you no need to do again this exercise. You just create one time, create table over the maintenance database. Okay, enter the name of the server that need to be patched in the format as below. If you look at this format, as I discussed above, you just need to give the server name, what are the server included in this patch. Okay, and then create the folder on the server that are going to be patched and placed the executable. So fourth step is you need to create a directory in each server and you need to place the executable under this directory. Okay, the fifth step is, you know, explanation of the SPA script is given written in the hash symbols. It's saying below is the script, the hash symbol is the explanation of the script. If you look at this PowerShell script, what it's saying, so if you look at this first comment, change the below highlighted path with that of your SQL Server database and table. The default means it's not named instance. So if you look at this here, default, so which means it's, you know, not named instance. You can change it accordingly based on your instance name. Okay, and this here, if you look at it, you need to give the credential, your credential. Here you need to provide your credential, and then if you come down here, you need to focus these two statements. Okay, so what's it saying? The like command contains the keyword from the services pack.exe where a new SP exe is released. You will need to add a new file else if else block and put the keywords from the SP. So basically it's saying you can, you know, add the new executables in this script actually in a future reference. Let's say it's a quite old 2012 SP3. If you look at for the, you know, 16 SP2 SP3, you can add it here with the if else command, you know. So so just you need to you know, add the statement based on the SQL patch released. Okay, so it will verify while doing the patching. So how it's working actually, so here it's, no, it's going to check whether the executable is SP12 SP3 in that particular server name, particular server under the directory, you know, the C SQL folder SP, then it will execute the that binaries. Else it will go to the further checks. If it is matched, then it will execute. If it is not matched, then it will come to the further checks, right? So like that this script is working based on the placed executable under the directory C SQL SP. It will matching and then it's executing from their side. Based on the PowerShell, it will establish the remote connection and it will execute the patch. It will restart the services and all. Okay, so your task is done. Now the sixth step is open the PowerShell window with the admin command and execute this statement, basically this statement from here to here. Once you verified the, you know, you modified the things what I said here, you just need to modify the logins, and here also the default things you need to modify it. Okay, so what I would do, I would share this document to you guys. If you want, you just do a comment, I will share to you. You go with these steps, definitely it will help for when you got the patching for the, you know, chunk of server. You just only need to check couple of things before executing these steps. You just only verify whether this you know, the win RM service is started on each server, what are the server included the patch. And the second thing, you know, you need to create this inventory on your maintenance database. Okay, so these exercise you need to do, and you need to place the server name here the created you are going to create the table, right, over the maintenance database. So you just only need to place the server name, and you need to create the directory, and you need to place the executable in that particular server under this directory. Let's say you have 10 server, just an example. So 5 server you need to place the 2012 SP2, and remaining you need to place the 2008 R2. So you just place the executable based on the need, actually. Okay, so this documents I have used, you can also use. Only the things is your jump server. From the jump server you can access the each server, what are the server included in a patch. Okay, so this will really helpful on, and the at the last you just only need to verify the logs. You no need to go to check the manually and all whether the patch succeeded or not. It will write the logs, if any failure it will write the logs. You just need to verify the logs, that's it. So it's some kind of, you know, on the avoiding the manual interaction, and you can save the time and you can make something interesting also. So that's it guys for today. If you like this, you know, document, you just give a comment, I will share with you. You can also utilize it, okay, and you can just give a try for a development environment. You just need to do some exercise. As I said, you need to create a temporary table, insert the server name and do some changing in a script and execute it. It will definitely work. You just need to check the remote connection and all. So if you like this video, you just give a, you know, thumbs up and share the video also to others. And if you need this document, you just give a comment, I will share with you. Thank you guys, thanks a lot.